In the not too distant future, next Sunday AD, there was a guy named Joel, not too different from you or me. He worked at his Monic Institute, just another face in a red jumpsuit. He did a good job cleaning up the place, but his bosses didn't like him, so they shot him into space.
It's present time. That's good. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Satellite of Love. I'm Joel Robinson, and I decided to give my bots a little pick-me-up today.
Nah, Gypsy, you didn't get anything. He forgot he had a robot named Gypsy.
Knock it off, you clown. You want to ruin present time by being naughty?
Hey, Gypsy girl, look what I got you. The Little Mermaid Ariel bath time set.
Me next.
Junior Dragster Indoor Funny Car by Marks.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, it goes up to 30 miles an hour, and if you run into a wall, it spins around, heads the other direction.
Wow, and it's got a tape deck.
Yeah, I didn't know what you liked, so I threw a few tapes in there.
Oh, I see Springsteen, Headies. These are great. Thanks, Joel.
Okay, what'd you get me, huh? Come on, let me have it.
I saved the best for last, Crow. I decided to give you some dress slacks from JCPenney.
Oh yeah,
come on, yeah. You'll get a lot of use out of them. You can use them for dressy or casual. And I'm going to have to get you a nice top too, maybe a pullover or something.
Sure. Commercial sign now.
You know, your birthday's coming up. Maybe I could get you some corrective shoes that match.
Thank you for the pants.
Boy, Crow, I sure wouldn't feel bad. Wait a minute. Ease down, Thundercloud. There we go. Sorry. You know, I sure wouldn't feel bad if I were you, Crow. Wish I could have gotten those pants. Yep, at least you can get some use out of them. You know, school, job interviews, interventions. Yeah, you're one lucky dog, Crow. Well, gotta go. Bye.
Woo! Oh, hey, Joel. Huh? The mad scientists are calling.
Oh, I'll get it.
This is our invention, Joel. Dr. Clayton Forrester and TV's Frank will now fulfill our destiny. The teasing jibes of classmates, the book dumping after typing class, the shameful expulsion from chess club. These are
Don't
only...
Don't forget all the power sit-ups they made you do.
Yes, exactly. They will bow down...
The revulsion, scorn, and rejection of all the pretty girls.
Yes, exactly. They shall pay
Sophomore
for...
Sophomore year and the shameful shower incident?
Yes, thank you, Frank. The point is that we shall cleave into this puny planet. We will crack the Earth as though it were a china cup, sending entire continents plummeting into the unforgiving sea. Prepare yourself.
Hey, may I ask a stupid question? Why are you guys doing this?
Yeah, what do you get out of it?
Well, you know, it's kind of a weird, you know, sort of Omega Man kind of thing.
No, it was more of a, why don't you go on with your invention, Joel?
Well, sirs, my invention today is Jim Henson's Edgar Winter Babies.
Well, I could see that. You know, I mean, they're little dolls, and there's no pigmentation.
Why don't we just call this one a draw, Robinson? Your movie for today's experiment makes even me sick, and I like Morgan Stewart's Coming Home. It's called Killer Shrews, and it stars James Best from Dukes of Hazzard fame, so Frank here is real excited.
Hey, it was my favorite show. What can I say? Oh, by the way, Joel, before the movie, there's a short. It's sort of a weird cowboy thing with horses and kids and...
Hollywood Movie Side!
Fun, huh?
Oh. Junior Rodeo Daredevil.
Smothered in gravy,
yes,
Texas style. Sir.
And
yeah.
It never would have happened without that old-timer, Billy Slater.
Yeah, he's doing a nickel up at
it
Attica.
It all began with a tin can.
Well, doesn't it always?
That's
it's the
little
gum
Bobby
jabal.
Lee on the left and my nephew Mike on the right.
Hmm. Jim Henson's misfit babies.
Bobby's taking the low road, and Mike's taking the high road.
Well, they get to Scotland before you.
Quite sure that Billy Slater won't notice them.
He's hammered.
And
oh.
Is he ever going to be surprised when his old nag starts running away from her own tail?
Hmm.
But this old-timer's been around.
Why, they're little...
Really got to know your stuff to fool him.
Get the shotgun. That'll learn
Just
him.
Watch.
Jeez, it's the heat!
Looks like the kid's in the stall.
Oh, I'm gonna teach you the meaning of law.
Come on, Quaker Oats for you. It's the right thing to do.
I'll chew pixies go through the barn or through the hayloft.
Sheriff Billy Slater has a hanging tree all ready for horse rustlers.
Hey, kids, you ever read the Oxbow incident?
Tough.
You know, he told Bobby and Mike,
if I like the girl, who cares what I like?
Many and hombre got hanged for fooling with horses. Hmm. But I've got another plan for you.
I'm going to bury you up to your necks.
So you think you know your way around horses?
Hmm. Sissy Spacer.
Well, here's what you're going to do. Organize a junior rodeo.
We're doomed.
Say, that's an idea.
Not a good one, but an idea.
Well, what we've got here are three ideas that our graphic guys came up with. I hope you like them.
Jim Henson's Last Picture Show, babies.
Another good one.
Well, sir, let me tell you. Our little old cow town never had seen such goings on. Billy's youngsters hit us with posters most everywhere we went.
Then they started hitting us with baseball bats.
Pretty soon we were just as head up about the junior rodeo as Billy and the kids themselves.
You call that art?
The whole town started getting the rodeo bug.
Yee-hoo.
That went for some of the best riders from the high school.
Hey, Mustang Sally.
Yeah. Old-timer Billy Slater was really doing a job with those kids.
Ah, rodeo's wasted on the young.
No, I see something subliminal in this here poster.
Seems like most everybody in town's turned out for the great day.
All nine of them.
There's Hank Evans' Angus bulls all slicked up for the rodeo.
Everybody digs Hank Evans. And
when you come right down to it, this whole rodeo is just another excuse to crawl inside a whiskey bottle.
Crawl.
Well,
going to be some tough competition here today. Calves for riding and roping. Into the corral with them.
Animals ought to be bred and slaughtered!
Ooh. Hey, Billy, I'll buy that rolling rock from you.
No way, beat it!
Everybody line up for the first race.
You're sloppy, you call that a line?
He's really helping the kids run their show.
Ah, Cafe Society. Ah.
And eat your oatmeal.
They're off.
I can't stop them, I don't know how it works. Goodbye, folks.
I think maybe rodeos are the opiate of the masses. These people.
Chuck Storm wins. That was a close finish.
And the crowd goes wild.
Yay!
And Mommy. There they go for the lead race.
Well, seems like being a cowboy would kind of suck. Mm.
Get off those horses fast. Run. Grab the bridle.
Come on, move it, move it, move it!
Suddenly, the game took a cruel turn.
Mm. Show 'em, cowgirl.
In the sand.
And the crowd goes wild.
Yay.
Calf roping time.
big, bold, and brassy.
There goes Mike.
Now, is that really an efficient way to bring food to market?
I don't think so.
Too bad. Better luck next time, kid.
Loser.
Sam Wood, champion calf roper of junior high.
No, the ironic thing is, Sam's a vegetarian, but there's nothing exciting about roping an okra patty.
Put him down, fella.
You were
seconds are going fast.
Now it's the calf dress-up competition.
Ooh.
26 seconds.
Yep, I'm hot. That's me pretty much.
We'll never escape this town.
Jim Rand, champion calf roper of senior high.
And next year's janitor.
Off his horse in a flash. Just like his dad at a big time rodeo.
Who left a legacy of secrets and shame.
You know, some scars don't heal. Up next is another young
yes,
fella.
Sir, 16 seconds.
What do you get?
And the crowd goes wild.
Yay!
Calf rider, stand by.
I don't really know what I'm doing! Oh!
Why can't Johnny ride?
Here comes Bobby. And there he goes.
Fortunately, Bobby didn't need his spine.
The girls aren't bashful either.
Like my friend Nietzsche said, that which does not kill you makes you stronger.
Oh, here comes
and
this
there
guy
goes the youngest bull rider
ow!
Of all.
Oh, you damn drat-a-tip. Ah, gee, criminy.
Go ahead. Strip me of my dignity at age four. What are you looking at?
What a pain.
And a tall for a calf rider.
Not anymore.
Betty's in high school.
Used to be.
Ouch.
You should see the boys when she goes square dancing.
Yeah, they buck her off right away.
Ew.
Oh, if I ever saw one.
Woof.
And here's a nosedive.
She can't take it there.
Anybody get a license number?
Hey. It's all the same for Mary Lou, beauty contest or calf riding.
Oatmeal's
she
done.
She can win them both. Yes, sir.
Yes, yes. Hey, honey, want to come to my pen for drinks later?
And the crowd goes wild.
Senior high bull riding.
Fresh off the grill.
This Angus bull is no hobby horse.
Now it's garbage.
He's a movable feast. Say.
Will you look at that bull? He's really mad.
Take the rope off my groin.
Here comes the last surviving castrati.
Only 2 years ago, he was still riding calves.
Now he sells pencils and string on street corners.
Dad's going to be mighty proud of him today.
If he can find him.
Ooh. Oh, no. Oh, no, this is wrong. I signed up for debate.
Just 6 seconds.
Over Tokyo.
And here's Slash Bar K's meanest bronc.
That horse has got Air Jordans on.
Clyde Burt sits him like he was glued to the saddle.
I am!
Hey, you're crowding my lane.
And the crowd goes wild.
Okay, Glenn, get out there and show him how to do it.
Or don't come home tonight.
Yeah.
I am not an animal.
Oh, yeah?
Watch out, that ground's awful hard.
Life is awful hard.
Yeah, we sure had us a junior rodeo.
Next week, geriatric rodeo.
And then it came prize-giving time.
First prize, Brown's cow chips.
Prizes for winning.
Even George F. Kaufman won a prize.
Prizes for trying.
In other words, bitter failure. It's Haley Mills.
I sure loved you in the Parent Trap.
Yes, sirree. The junior rodeo is here to stay.
Yep.
And nobody's happier about it than old-timer Billy Slater.
It's sad, really.
And the guys are not clowning all day.
Those who hunt by night
will tell you that the wildest and most vicious of all animals
are in Vegas
is the tiny shrew.
A shrew? Come on.
Feeds only by the dark of the moon.
Yeah, just go with us on this,
he
okay?
He must eat his own body weight every few hours.
Plus a delicious shake.
And the shrew devours everything. Ooh. Bones, flesh, marrow, everything.
Yeah, he can really tuck away
in
the groceries.
First in Alaska, and then invading steadily southward.
Weird.
There were reports of a new species.
A fun
the
species.
Giant killer shrew.
So there!
Duh. Killer.
Killer.
Sure. Starring that. Joan Collins and Jackie Collins.
Hmm. Oh, Ingrid is good, but James is best.
I think so.
Based on a novel by William Shatner. Spock.
Oh, the great William M. Klein. Little friend.
Ooh, I passed a bluestone last night, let me tell you. Ooh.
No shrews were hurt during the making of this picture.
Well, a few, but... Big Ben Chapman! Bold.
Matthew, if you ain't the orneriest frog that ever jumped on a log.
Hey, Ray Kellogg, he directed the giant Gila monster.
Oh, no! Oh, it's Robert Maxwell's belt. Mr. Maxwell! Mr. Maxwell!
Oh. Hey, it's PT90210. Check it out.
Oh, there's a lot of quiet out there.
Too lot of quiet.
Almost smelt, can't you?
Oh, that's me.
No, but I can feel it. The pressure's dropped so fast, it's almost made my ears pop.
Chew gum.
Hurricane's got different ways of telling you it's there. Waves.
I thought you knew.
Get ahead.
You think I'm heavy?
What's that mean, though? My boy, that puts our port right in the middle of it.
Oh, God, help me.
There's a cove on the lee side, though. We'll snuggle up close to the bluff and ride it out.
You most certainly will not.
Well, the chart shows it's good holding ground. It's clay.
Yeah.
You know something?
What?
If this thing had an automatic pilot, I wouldn't have to put up with you. Then you wouldn't have nobody to chew out.
Yeah, wait till the whip comes down, white boy.
Be there in a couple of hours. These mills of yours keep running. Look. Automatic pilots can't play Dixieland jazz on them engines like I can.
Good point. What the heck did that mean?
They're trolling kind of fast, aren't they?
You're gonna lose bait.
Hey, Rook. Rook, come here.
These things make everything look bigger.
Take a look. There she is, dead ahead.
Oh, yeah, it's Gilligan's Island, the Headhunter episode.
Man, that sure do look good.
Mrs. Howell?
Man named Craig is on this island, doesn't he? That's the name on the crate, Dr. Milo Craig. We'll unload tomorrow. I don't want this crap sitting high in that water when that flow hits.
You're
right,
yes.
Stirring too, with a lot of water under?
That's right. That sea won't make up in that cove. That wind will have her whipping around like a kite. Step forward and break out the heavy weather hook.
Okay. Yeah, but a heavy weather hook can't play Dixieland jazz.
All right, Joel, all right.
Hey, say, like Robinson Crusoe, this is as primitive as can be.
Bet Robinson Crusoe can't play Dixieland jazz.
Would you knock it off about Dixieland jazz?
Oh, jeez. I know this. This is the famous dock walking scene. You know, this whole take was done in one shot. It's a planned sequence, like the opening of Touch of Evil and the Copacabana scene in Goodfellas. Mm-hmm. This is virtuoso filmmaking, fellas. You got to see it to believe it. You know, Brian De Palma used this in the Bonfire of the Vanities, and it's really exciting. It's splendiferous. No?
Well, we've covered the waterfront.
She'll ride like a duck. Swings too far to starboard, we might have to take a check line to shore.
Yeah, whatever.
Hey, Rook, take a slant up that trail.
Hey, this island's got oak trees.
Well, that's a rather strange setup, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, but the punchline makes it work.
Like somebody's getting rid of somebody.
Sometime.
Mm-hmm. Maybe. Hard to tell.
But I bet they can't play Dixieland jazz like
that.
Like Columbus, we claim this island for... Oh, hi.
I'm the temp you ordered.
I'm Dr. Fake.
Yeah, right, whatever. Who's the lady?
Have your supplies aboard.
That's good.
Nothing wrong with Captain Ferguson, I hope.
Well, I wouldn't know.
Never heard of Slim Fast?
I just bought his rhyme.
Oh, I see. Were you able to fill our order?
Everything on the list. Here's the manifest.
Destiny.
Missing last week's supply has run us a little short. Yeah. Captain, after you have unloaded, I have a passenger for you. And? Captain Sherman, this is my daughter, Anne Craig.
So, hands off.
Hello. So you're the passenger?
That's right, Captain.
Oh, it's going to be nice having you aboard. I'm getting a little tired looking at Griswold.
Can you play Dixieland Jazz?
We're not leaving today.
Oh, well, I,
We're not even unloading.
In fact, we don't even exist.
That load will cut the roll in half.
Now, wait, you don't have a line yet. Where are you?
Yes, animals. Game or otherwise. Under certain conditions, it could be dangerous.
He's right, you know.
Hey, Ruff, you want to shake the kinks out? Limber up a little?
Not me, Captain Light. You go right ahead and stretch your legs. That ship's going to be bugging like a bucket frog for a long. Besides, I got some work left to do.
A simple yes or no will do.
If you come ashore, wear a gun.
Gotcha, Captain. And if you go to San Francisco, wear some flowers in your hair.
Gotcha, Captain. Oh, he must be scouting locations for Dukes of Hazzard, right? Mm.
Boss Hogg will love this place.
So they went a bit overboard on the fence.
No sense of perspective.
You know, they should have put a gate in it, for crying out loud.
I've fallen in with a group of ham radio operators.
No.
When I told you about the hurricane, you act like you didn't know anything about it.
Hurricane Carter?
What's the matter? Your set broken down? You've been out of communication for more than a week, Captain. Can't be fixed. It's totally out of commission.
What he said?
My assistant. Mr. Farrell. Jerry Farrell.
Jerry Farrell? Hey, did he go to Harrelson Elementary School?
Oh.
Hey, Freddy Fender.
Would you join us in a cocktail?
Well, I've never been known to turn down a drink yet. I'll be glad to accept it.
I've been known to beg for him, as a matter of fact.
In that case, we'll have martinis. Mario? Si, senor?
Who?
Nixon, please.
Nixon, please? Mm-hmm. What's he talking about?
What a scene.
Right this way, Captain.
You hear those little cocktail napkins with the jokes on them? I love those little guys.
Check your gun at the door, Festus.
There. Bad door.
Okay, don't say hi. Gah.
Sounds like Flash Gordon.
What a dump. Who said that, George?
Everything here you need? We are self-sufficient here. We have cows for fresh milk, chickens for fresh eggs.
Gin, rum, pickled eggs, mixers.
Sort of a world all your own. It's exactly what I've tried to create.
Well, to each his own. If you have to be isolated for your work, you picked a lonely little island.
What are you getting at? What's your point?
Excuse me, please. I think I'll change.
Why'd you go and say that to her? Jeez, let's leave.
Tom, I knew that shirt was going to push some bad buttons for Joel and get him started doing that Will Rogers thing he's been talking about.
And you were right, Crow. Oh, by the way, I do love those pants.
Oh, yeah, the pants.
Here he comes.
Well, howdy, folks. How you doing? You know, I've been listening to what the president's been doing, and it kind of seems to me like he's trying to crawl into the wrong end of the Cracker Barrel. Yuck.
Bristle, I guess.
Yeah, I'm a lot like you folks. I'm simple, you know, and I've been hearing the president go on, and it kind of seems to me like the polecat's got caught in the cow, and it's time for the hound dog to skitter him out of there.
Hey, yeah. This is fun.
You're pretty good at it, too.
Oh, yeah. Bristle. You know, kind of reminds me of Aunt Martha's mustache, you know? Makes a fella hungry for some down-home dogfish, don't it?
What?
The rumors of my death have been greatly exaggerated.
That's not Will Rogers.
Yep, it's not over till it's over.
And that's Casey Stengel. What's he doing?
I don't know. It's
crazy. Oh, well, everything I love is either illegal, immoral, or fattening. Huh? Take a bite out of crime.
Wait a minute. Alexander Wolcott and McGruff, he's all over the map. Joel, you okay? Come here, buddy.
Yep, we Joel. Will bury you.
Khrushchev. Oh, Joel.
Yep, baseball been very, very good to me.
Oh, now he's doing Garrett Morris.
Really
He's just toying with us. Yeah, let's
I'm
get out of here.
Out.
Anybody here seen my old friend John?
Joel, let me go. I want to go iron my pants.
Yep. It's morning in America.
No, it is not.
Yep. One fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish.
Bristle,
hey,
bristle,
I thought
bristle.
You're going to hurt somebody with this thing.
Well, it's your idea.
John, I'm leaving until tomorrow. I can understand that. But there's something else
Ouch.
Bothering
Sorry.
You.
How would you know?
Hey.
Bob Clampett. So, how's your novel coming along there?
Rapid?
Bathroom?
Rapid, would you please step over here? I'd like you to meet
bathroom?
Someone. Just a second, Doc.
Yes, this is our resident novelist. Rapid bathroom.
Dr. Bain.
Hmm?
There's no need to shout, Doctor. I'm right here. I'd like you to meet Captain Thorne Shrimp.
Stone Shrimp?
Rapid Bain. How do you do? Two new litters since lunch, Doctor.
Whoa.
Both support GT116. Hmm? That's good, but we can breed them to the 205 group in about 3 weeks. But I'd prefer to wait and expose about half of them to the Hoskins
Hey,
factor
relax!
First, if you agree. Good idea. Do you know there's a hurricane coming?
No, but if you hum a few bars...
Well, I don't suppose there's much we can do about that. Glad to meet you.
Could you get me a few Denver Pyle autographs?
We need the eggs, as they say.
You have to excuse that, bud.
He smells.
Anything that does not concern this project does not get through to him. Brilliant mind. He would start at it if someone didn't remind him to eat. Must be very interesting work. What's his field?
Of dreams.
Biology. He specialized in genetics, heredity. I'm afraid my interest doesn't run in that line, you know. think what
get
would
out.
Happen if you could isolate and identify the inherited fact on each gene. Now, wait a minute. I'm afraid I'm not very good with your research. This is practical research.
I'm not good at that either.
Generally among mammals, the smaller the size, the higher the metabolism and the shorter the lifespan.
Is that right?
Well, I'm attempting to decrease the size by maintaining a low metabolism and resultant a longer lifespan.
What reason?
You'd think he'd come up with a hair growth thing if he was so smart.
Yeah.
I'd like to hit you really hard.
Not a problem now, but it will be in time.
Hey, it's Cousin Marilyn from the Munsters.
Oh. If we were half as big as we are now, we could live twice as long on our natural resources.
Hmm? She's got her apron on backwards.
Father, may I speak with you a moment? Will you please excuse us, Captain?
Well, providing you drop the Captain, I prefer a thorn.
Dad, this scientist thing is cute, but it's wearing thin.
Mm-hmm, that's good booze.
Tell him now.
Tell me something, Doctor.
Why do fools fall in love?
Has a hurricane ever hit this island before that you know of? I wouldn't know. You've only been here 9 months and this place has been unoccupied for years.
Well, have you ever been through one?
Have you ever been mellow?
Only the fringes.
Well, this one's building up very fast. Pressure drops very quickly in the center. I'd advise you to get some doors and windows open in this place.
Yes, Mr. Ventilation.
Ventilate us on the roof. And if you'll flesh in man's drink, I'll go and check them.
Flesh in man's drink?
I don't get it.
Thank heavens, you're right.
Frost him all.
Why, are rations getting short?
Oh, it's more than that. Much more. We'll surely be able to sail tomorrow, won't we?
Possibly. But not probable. Not delayed, anyway. Mm. Takes a long time for a sea like that to quiet down.
Well, if you're worrying about me, you needn't. I'm a good sailor.
Aye, all hands on deck.
You'll say all the time's right. Got them opened, all right.
That's great. Now close
well,
them
Captain,
up.
Let me freshen you a drink.
Flesh and drink again?
What do you
say? I'm trying to rush you, but...
Get out! Get out!
I've invited someone for dinner, Father.
Does anybody know the plot yet?
Oh?
I see.
London, I see France.
If you're not worried about your ship, you're welcome. I'll take a rain check on that dinner, if you wish.
Father, I've asked Thorne to stay.
Hey, everybody, what does this remind you of?
Doctor.
He's a brilliant man, but he saves his flag.
Survivor of Group 30, 28 months old today.
Happy birthday to you.
That's right, yet it still maintains low metabolism without any sluggishness.
The guy who taught LBJ how to hold dogs.
It certainly sets our course. Rapport, suspend series 52 Rapport. Through a...
What the heck is he talking about?
What is that? It's a thorax sericity.
But I call him Rick.
Looks like a small rat. Mm-hmm. Smells like a skunk.
Looks delicious.
They have much plans in their knees. These little fellows are our subjects. They have a birth cycle of 10 to 14 days.
Hmm?
And using them, we can establish traits.
This guy makes Al Lewis look handsome.
For a number of generations over a short period of time.
Uh-huh.
Well, how big do they get?
How big does that music make it sound?
That's an adult.
I've got a big, dirty secret.
See, the muscle is longer and thicker than the rat's.
Thicker?
It extends over the lower mandible.
Huh.
See?
Guys, want to get back to the movie?
Be nice.
Only when he's hungry. Well,
I can't think of my line.
All he knows is his next meal.
Which is you.
He's just been fed. He'll be all right for another 8 hours.
Honey, switch to decaf.
The shutter door open. Rapport, I got it.
Oh, watch it.
Did that scare you?
Does it bug you?
Storm has always threatened her ever since she was a child. They're not climbers. They're digging animals, a lot like the mole.
Let me drop it on your shirt.
They feed only at night unless they're starving. And when they are hungry enough, they'll tackle anything regardless of size.
Like LT, Lawrence Taylor.
If you leave two of them in a cage for 12 hours without food, the stronger will eat the weaker.
It's fun.
Cannibals, precisely. You see,
don't say
their
cannibal.
Their activity requires a tremendous amount of energy. To supply, they must eat three times their own weight in food every 24 hours or starve.
Guys, this was covered at the voiceover at the beginning of the movie.
All right, I want you to pick a card, any card. Out of the middle of the deck is fine now.
Some call them bone eaters.
I call them cheddarwurst.
When the flesh is gone, they'll eat the bones from marrow. All they'll leave are teeth, horns,
I could use another martini. Do you mind?
Of course, my dear. I'll get you one.
You don't pick your family, do you?
Just humor him. He's not well. Hi.
What?
Drink it down.
Mario!
Yes, Mr. Benny!
Thank you for that. Mario was shown to the bath. He will freshen up a bit. Here be el señor al baño.
Si, señor. Sígame, por favor.
Hit him with the bathroom?
Bonita, what are you trying to prove?
Finish your drink.
Well, listen, here's the caveman room. You'll really enjoy it.
Charles Bukowski was here before you. Sorry about the mess.
The martini faucet's in back there. Oh, I found it.
Strip over the towel. It's sanitized for my protection, huh?
Hey. Is your room comfortable, sir? Can I unpack your hat?
Please don't drink from the bidet.
You got a problem, too? Que paso?
Nada.
Okay. Nada, senor. But you will leave on the ship tomorrow. Well, I think that all depends on the wind and the sea, don't you?
Regular Walt Whitman, aren't you?
I don't know. You may joke. I feel the point. I see. I'm glad to hear that. If anybody else is concerned about my sailing tomorrow, why, you see, they feel the point too, huh?
Ouch.
I don't like to repeat myself. Okay, senor?
He's got to plug in the boat for the night.
Yeah. Aw, someone let the cake out in the rain. What's the, over there? Oh, I get it. This is Knott's Landing. don't.
Hey, it's funny. I like that one.
I know, but I'm not saying that you created them, Jimmy. I am saying that because of your drunken stupidity in leaving the cage door open, you created the horrible situation that now exists.
Now, Miss Kitty,
mistake any one of us might have made. I'm getting a little sick of being called an irresponsible drunk. Now, believe me, I am.
Hi, it's irresponsible drunk. Oh, there you are.
Excuse me.
Two people per scene, please.
All right, I'm leaving, and as soon as I close the door, I'm gone, all right? So, Shrew?
Care for a cigarette?
Why, thank you. I have emphysema.
Thank heavens you arrived today.
You said that before. What's the strain?
That don't make sense.
Oh, nuts. I got my shirt caught in the door.
It seems like everything is coming to a head at once. I want to leave, but I want my father to go with me.
Well, then, why doesn't he?
We've discussed it many times, but he's adamant.
Oh, he's adamant.
I'm sure Jerry has a lot to do with his decision.
Hey, who's this Jerry the wiener? Oh, I'm Jerry.
He had to convince me that the crisis will only last for a few...
Hi.
What?
Hey, see, I forgot my thing, and well, I need it for this thing I'm doing.
This is certainly a cozy little scene.
It was gonna be cozy.
Might even be called intimate. Boy meets girl...
Stop it, Jerry. That remark is uncalled for. What I do or have to say does not concern you.
I can't disagree with you more, my dear. I'm concerned with everything you do, and I intend to keep it that way.
I'm out of here.
On my book, an engagement isn't a casual thing.
In my book, it isn't either. And last night ended ours.
Dorothy! Dorothy!
Hey, that sounds like a Dixieland jazz band.
He's doing it.
Stop it.
Uh-oh.
Cute little gun. Puppies. Sit, stay, sit, or you stay. You stay. Sit. Oh yeah, look at those pants go.
Kind of feels good.
Mm.
Oh, big dog. Oh, run. Oh, just.
Gee, they're just puppies. What's he running from puppies for?
Hi there, I'm Kurt Gowdy. We're out hunting with George Kirby from Big Texas Shrew, and it's really not going that well.
Ren, Stimpy, no!
Go away! I'll hump you!
Hey, just throw us your wallet! Wait till I finish my Saratoga.
Everybody in the world is scared to death of something.
That's evident. When they came at us last night, you knocked me down getting inside the fence.
It's just that I can't stand them.
And I've discovered something I can't stand.
Speckle. It bugs me.
All right. But I advise you not to mention it to anyone.
And don't leave the
country.
I'm going
to complete these experiments with your father regardless of anything. Do you understand that? Nobody is going to take this chance away from me.
Your breath smells like feet.
Let's get the shed.
Checking the weather, I'll get him. Time for dinner.
Man, it's really breezy in my room.
We're having tobacco salad with a light gin dressing.
Meanwhile, back at the branch.
Don't!
Hang in there, baby. Friday's coming.
Ooh.
You know, this is another one of those scenes that is so offensive on so many levels.
I hear you. Mm. Uh-oh, he's shooting the branch.
A little Roscoe for you, Shrew.
Oh, they're licking me. Stop it. No, stop. Cut it out. No, it tickles.
They're licking him to death.
No,
cute.
Shaking the bush, boss.
He exploded.
I hate the smell of wet Shrew.
Are the dogs and Shrews friends? Is that what's going on?
I think I just heard Griswold explode. You?
It's a mile, I always say.
You mean one of those trees crashes through, it might just
look,
knock
honey,
the
any tree on this side of the house will fall away from it, so just relax.
Well, you're a tree surgeon now.
I think I'd better go back aboard. I don't think I'm not grateful for your hospitality. I am.
But you're out of liquor, so...
Your ship is safe. Please, stay here with me.
Is there somebody Why? Under that dress?
You scared or lonesome?
Chicken. Chicken.
I'll take a rain check on it.
Thorn, you can't leave. No one opens that gate after dark.
Well, who's going to stop me? You?
What's this?
How about my friend Roscoe?
No one opens that gate at night.
Open that gate! Come on, Rabbit! Open that gate!
Now, look, I don't ask questions because it's against my principles.
Do I?
Wouldn't you like to explain that?
Well, you see, the hammer hits the primer, and the primer...
Give me the gun. Yeah. Not very becoming, anyway.
Oh, rats.
You believe in fairy tales?
Does it got elves in it?
Well, I'm a little old for that sort of thing, but what'd you have in mind?
Well, I'll tell you about one. A true fairy tale. And you're right in the middle of it.
Oh?
Have you ever heard of a shrew?
Gesundheit.
As in taming
of the... Well, the animal. Dad will call them sorcery when he showed you one.
Oh, then shrew must be the common name for those cute little animals.
Cute?
Well, they're adorable.
That's the last word you can use to describe this little monster. They're the most horrible animals on the face of the earth.
A murderer?
My father told you they breed within 3 weeks after birth. They last them
yeah, yeah,
1 year.
I know what your father told me, but what's that got to do with me opening that gate?
Pick another category, please. Still your turn.
There are 200 or 300 giant shrews out there.
Not counting the dogs, right?
Monsters weighing between 50 and 100 pounds.
How does she weigh them?
50 to 100
pounds?
Wait a minute, you must be kidding.
I'm definitely not kidding.
I'm not pulling your wig.
That's as big as a full-grown wolf.
And what's more, they are beginning to starve.
She's got a real Hawaii 5-0 hairdo there. Hmm.
No wonder you didn't want me to go out there. Hey. Thanks for saving my skin.
Well, I'm sorry I had to threaten you with a gun. But I didn't know how else to stop you.
Oh, it was very effective.
Quite a turn.
But all you had to do was tell me about them.
What is this, fill in the blank?
I wouldn't have to. But you changed everything when you started to leave. And I had to stop you some way.
I would have been alone. I'd rather kill you than
See,
be alone.
See, there's 200 or 300 out there?
Where'd they get our address?
Sam.
Well, now, Matthew, I sure could use a gimlet.
That's right, Captain Thorne. And if you'd stuck with your rowboat and played captain instead of trying to play detective, you wouldn't have to worry about how many are out there, would you? That's enough, Jerry.
That's a pretty complex insult for a drunk.
Mm-hmm. Well, now it's like an Agatha Christie novel.
What's wrong, Anne?
Well, Thorne decided to leave. To dissuade him, I started to tell him about the shrews.
Shrews? What about... Oh, shrews! Oh.
You might as well know the whole story, as half of it.
Story?
Doesn't anybody think about Griswold?
I've heard this one before.
I guess you're all a little jumpy, Captain.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
You're about to light the filter, Captain.
6 months ago, we managed to isolate the factor control inside.
What a night that was.
2 liters of warm. 6 individuals we kept for study.
A prosthetic?
They were about the size of buckshot at birth.
Hey, he's
But the
bald.
Rate of growth was abnormal.
I'm on the edge of my chair.
They continued to grow.
Whoa.
They were mutants. But they inherited all the negative characteristics of their species. Somehow they managed to escape.
Killer shrew, killer shrew. Don't know the difference between me and you. He comes out at night to give you a fright. Don't look now, but he's gonna take a bite. Killer shrew, killer shrew. K-I-L-L-E-R shrew. He's scary and tough, if that ain't enough. He's augmented with bath mats and stuff. Killer shrew, killer shrew. He's coming to your town to get you.
Killer shrew by Marks.
Alright, that was great.
Okay, Consumer Joel, that's the enticing jingle. Now play the super fun board game.
Wait a minute, you guys came up with this all by yourselves?
El Pazavito, Senorito. Come on, let's play. All you right. can be the German guy, and I'll pick a card right over there.
All right, okay, gotcha. All right. It says contemplate shrews?
Yeah. Okay, that means you don't move. Okay, now I pick one.
Okay,
pick one
for me. I'll do okay. that for you. Okay.
Okay, have another martini.
Ooh, good one.
Okie doke, I'm the girl, so right. I'll just move one piece. Okay. Move for, okay. You see, it's glued down, right. and you can't move it. It's right. just like the movie. Uh-huh. Nobody moves. Yeah. In fact, nobody moves at all for over 45 minutes. It's enough to numb your brain. They sit and talk and nothing happens, and then cripes, Frank Cannon gets more action than this. You think something might happen to your spirit, sorry, but all that happens is the black girl changes. She's not even that cute. Crow. And the Juma guy mumbles, and so does the captain, and everyone just drinks more.
That's
scared. The only thing that gives me that I keep feeling in the can't tell what this is.
That's okay. That's okay. Joel's got you. It's all right. It's okay. No, you guys didn't have to do this for me. You're both such troopers in the theater, quipping like there's no tomorrow, making kooky comments on contemporary mores, you know, making arcane references at the drop of a hat. I love you, little guys.
Thanks, Joel. We love you, too.
It's just, you were so funny in the theater. He didn't know if you could tell this movie was a honk shoe.
A honk shoe? What's that?
You know, honk shoe, honk shoe, honk shoe.
But I'm all sleeping. Never multiply.
Oh, this.
We did everything in the world to exterminate them, but no apparent luck.
Did you try a roach motel?
And we haven't seen any. Since daylight just blinds them and they forage only at night when they're starving.
He's got a few hairs left up there.
But the fact that two of them charged Anne and Jerry at the gate last evening indicates that the available food on the island is nearing depletion.
Well, let's have a food drive.
Then what, Doctor? They will exterminate. Well,
that's it. Don't you get it?
It'll take a couple days.
What do we do during that time?
Well, there's always liquor.
Stay indoors and wait until it's over.
Oh, no! They've got wire cutters!
Uh-oh. Some wires blew down on the transformer.
Yep.
I'm sorry.
Everyone, quick, light your martinis.
Mario!
See?
There's a liner in the pantry. Light it and bring it in here.
I'll fix the drinks.
Bradford, light all the candles you can find.
And curse the darkness.
Bring the generator.
Outside. Can't get at it at night.
She's kind of wearing fluffy culottes, mm-hmm. isn't she?
The lantern will give you all the light you need.
It's just as light with candles.
Amazing. This is like a bad production of a Chekhov play. Mm-hmm. Wild geese.
I don't like you.
Well, Jerry, I felt she was sincere and made sense from her standpoint.
Stop talking and finish my pedicure.
Wanting her father to leave the island with her makes sense.
Now spit.
It'd be much better for the project if I went with her for a few days.
Maybe the Fanta Suites.
Matter of fact, I think I'll talk to the doctor about that. That might be the answer.
Well, great. It'll be a 20-minute scene,
thing,
I'm sure.
I don't take much to this Thorn Sherman. He looks to me like the type that'd try anything.
Oh, really? I think he's a really nice guy.
That left-handed dinner invitation. That was just to keep me here till after dark, wasn't it?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was sure you were left-handed. Can you eat with either hand?
I wanted you here tonight. I thought something terrible was going to happen.
Well, you still feel the same way about it?
Not as much. Not since you're here and know everything.
I don't know everything. I don't even know how fish work.
Oh, puppy!
No, not Fury!
The biggest shrew of all!
That was weird.
I love an open fire, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're great.
And I love an open sewer.
The wind has a lonesome sound, doesn't it?
Wheat. Sure. Nothing but miles of wheat.
Back in Sweden, we don't have a wind this strong.
Tell me about your home world, Ursul.
You're a strange man, Thorn.
You're a queer dog.
I never met anyone like you.
Oh?
You seem so disinterested in everything.
Look, you bore the heck
aren't
out of me.
Aren't you the least bit curious?
Yellow?
Don't you wonder about the unusual things around here?
Do you ever wonder where felt comes from?
The guns, the fins. shattered windows?
Believe it or not.
Anything?
I'll tell you something. I'm only interested in anything that concerns me, then I do something about it.
Did you say Frau Blücher?
You're going to stay with me tomorrow, whether your father intends to.
Did you just whinny?
He was Mr. Ed.
No, don't go in the bathroom. We don't have a fan in there.
Huh?
Ken Curtis and Ken Curtis in Double Impact.
I couldn't take a chance. He's fool enough, too.
Don't be stupid. I
had
no intentions of going out there, opening that gate. Now,
my mouth's bleeding, Bert.
Did you hear it, Doctor? Sound like a human voice. I was thinking a rook. It was the livestock. The shoes got into the bar.
The shoes got into the bar?
I better put some alcohol on this wound.
Let me guess, the shoes in the bar.
What was it, Father?
The livestock.
Livestock, that? Hmm? Huh?
Did Mario forget to bar those doors?
Booze, glorious booze.
No. I put them in the bar myself.
What about a bar mitzvah?
I don't get it.
Couldn't get through the wood doors. A dug through the dirt floor. Let me ask you something, Doctor.
Where are the olives?
How could you expose all our lives, yourself included, with those things out there?
Did he just become more southern?
All you had to do was get the Coast Guard or the Navy to come in here and burn them out.
Give me that.
Those things got loose. Any unusual experiment can produce unusual results.
Hey, that was my drink.
That's why I chose this island. It's isolated. Miles of open water in any direction.
Miles O'Keefe in every direction.
Our project is privately financed.
Here comes Art Buchwald again.
Not a problem for the government or military. The world is no danger.
I've been going through the script and I think I'm in this scene.
His species does not swim.
Yes, fishes do swim. Turn,
this island is their world.
And welcome to it.
Very soon, right here on this island.
Appearing will
be
Don Bo.
A miniature reproduction of an overpopulated world.
That will bring in the tourists.
And you'll see the importance of what we're working to avoid. I'm not concerned about all this theory. What I'm concerned about is our lives.
And my rap
boy. Have time to panic when they run out of food and go on a 24-hour forage. How do you know they haven't already?
Yes, say yes to
their
Martini and Rossi.
Their main diet has been the small animals on the island. That source could have been depleted.
We need more brandy. Need more scotch. We're out of vanilla extract.
As a livestock. There's still some food on this island before they reach the crisis.
Microbe. He's big mouth.
What? It's paid for, okay?
Don't worry about them digging in here. The floors are tiled, but the walls aren't, Doctor. They're adobe.
Gillis.
Our safest bet would be on that boat. You may be right.
I may be crazy.
You can reach your boat in daylight. The shrews will gorge themselves on life.
Booze is for healing.
That should keep them lethargic for several hours. There's no sense looking at the dark side.
People.
And there's no sense minimizing a serious situation. It leaves you completely unprepared to cope with it.
Hey.
Well, you took mine earlier.
Now, we certainly can't make it tonight. That's out of the question.
Maybe the next day, someday, and soon.
Synchronized drinking.
I haven't. We'll get some sleep tonight. But we'll have a watch, an hour and a half apiece. Doctor, you go first, and then Radford.
Like I mentioned.
Jerry, and then me.
They're setting up a quarters
game.
Shutter
all the windows. Make sure they're locked good and tight. Check all these walls.
And roll the brewmaster in here so it's closer.
Come on.
No, I think I'll stay here by the fire. I feel safer.
And closer to the bar.
I couldn't stand it in that room alone.
All right, as you wish. But fart to get some sleep.
What, fart and get some sleep?
You know what I've been thinking about, Mario?
Socks. I don't know why.
Dan? And that captain?
Oh, the space captain fantasy again.
You and me.
We will need a bigger room, then.
Imagine an intelligent girl like her going for a common sea tramp like him.
Imagine in how much detail, senor.
I know why. You do, too.
Pourquoi?
In case anything goes wrong, she's looking out for her own hide.
Okay. He's difficult.
That's why I keep thinking about you and me.
And Bobby McGee?
Anything goes wrong...
I'm not Lisa. My name is Mario.
We're gonna outlast them all.
Sinners, repent!
Let's get out of here, Scooby!
Shudder.
I'm going to trust you
to tell me when I've had enough.
It's my turn of patrolling the house. But when you finish, don't wake the captain. Come back here and get me.
Drunk.
See, I'll probably feel good enough by then to take his turn.
He's having his blood replaced.
Okay, Maya?
Okay.
Okay.
Don't touch me.
Let's see. What am I? Bacon. I want some bacon here. Love bacon. No, he chewed up the slippers. Bedroom. Bedroom. Mr. Foggy. Mr. Foggy. Polly.
Little puppy.
The shrews know they're supposed to close the door.
Now, let's see. I'd better finish up those pies before the shrews get them. Sure is taste tempting, all those lamb yummy pies.
Mm-hmm. Okay, right over left, then left. No, no, you got a granny knot.
Senor, it is Mario.
Oh, sir, pull up the cover.
Please.
A shrew in the cellar? Si, I hear him singing down there.
He was singing?
How did he get in? The storm broke out the kitchen window, but I closed it off. He went down there.
Why should he go down there?
The food for the little ratones. I put it out to frost, they love it.
What was that about cojones?
Did you tell Jerry?
No, senor. Here is your turn next. Here is una luz. We kill him,
una luz? Oh, yeah. Flashlight. That's what he's trying to say. Oh.
It's Dave Lennox, and Dave Lennox in the Lint Trap.
Honey? Honey, we're at Grandpa's, dear. Wake up.
Man, I don't mean to be rude, but your eyes look like two pee holes in the snow.
Soccer team!
Down the cellar. Now, we're going down after him. But I don't want you to let anybody open that door till I tell you to. Understand?
Okay, anybody can open the door when you tell me what... Wait. I wasn't awake enough. What did you say?
Shrew, puppy, I mean shrew.
Oh, this is just like aliens, except without the underwear.
Uh-huh. Ooh, I like the underwear.
Open just a crack.
Okay.
How come I have to open it?
Hold on to it.
Abra la puerta.
Okay.
Freeze!
Oh, better my la puerta.
Well, this is just like that Happy Days or Perfect Strangers or Full House or Empty Nest or Just the Ten of Us episode when they get stuck in the basement.
Gin? Vermouth? This is where they keep it all.
Oh, I've been pulling this. Oh no, there's a Teddy Roosevelt costume and some greys down here!
Ah, there's a Muppet behind the stairs!
No.
It's alright under the stairs.
It's alright!
Honey, I think we got puppets down here.
Hand puppets?
Yeah, they're under the stairs, so I don't think they're marionettes.
Tasty milk bones. Rawhide shrew toys.
Mario?
Fine, thanks.
You see anything? I see where he was. Mm-hmm. I will not see where he is. Mirado, si, senor. I will be careful.
Careful?
Oh no, I got Trudeau on my shoe!
Ooh!
Weasels rip my flesh!
Bad puppet! Oh, would've got here sooner, but it's a big basement.
Please don't ask me to suck out the venom.
I thought you said your dog doesn't have bad.
Isn't that my dog? Well, it's the Booze Brothers to the rescue.
Beware the dwarf.
What is it, boy?
We will prevail. Our state fair is a great state fair. Try the veal.
You all right down there? Doctor,
I'm fine, but Mario's not doing so hot.
Yo, bad idea.
Hey, get off him!
No, he's got an injury, see?
Where'd you hide the Cuervo?
Oh, well, he's got rat scratch fever. Oh.
Oh, crap, look at the time. I gotta get the thing. I gotta go.
He's dead.
He's red?
Yeah.
He's fed?
He's Ed.
Ed.
Oh. Oh, thank goodness.
I got this on him right away. He couldn't have bled to death.
Face it, it's your fault.
Yep.
Might as well let go of it. Won't do him any good now.
I'll get a body bag out of the closet. Can I have my gun back?
What could have killed him?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe that shrew?
I'm not certain. Till the autopsy.
Hemotoxic syndrome.
Sounds like a Ludlum book.
I'm afraid so. We'll know after pathology.
Scatology? Doctor, you studied dung?
Ooh. That's not the same animal you showed me. That's a monster.
He grew
As
up.
As I said, they're mutants.
Ted mutants.
They're controlling the size factor.
Ooh, that's a stretch.
They seem to have crossed some of the other characteristics. Well, you certainly did a good job of it.
Well, thank you.
I've known that for some time, Captain.
Ooh, I'm sorry. I had that coming.
Now I'd like to say a prayer if nobody minds. There, done.
Please Lord. Give me a hand, Mario. Bradford, bring up the animal.
Tonight, all dogs go to hell.
Look, he's levitating.
Next week on Killer Shrews.
Turns out it needs more vermouth. Taste it, see what you think.
Extremely high poison content in the shrew's saliva.
But it's smooth over ice.
Now compare it with this. Careful count isn't necessary. Mm-hmm. Any indication of the same poison in Mario's blood same will give you the answer. Mm-hmm. Yes, you're right.
Oh, I get it. Mario's gonna become a shrew.
Look, Ann.
You know, you're really a drag on these weekend getaways, Dig.
Brooding about it's not gonna do any good.
But breeding will.
Now, why don't you try to think of something else? Tell me,
Do you collect plates or anything?
Are you a scientist?
No, I sweep up. What do you think?
Oh. That's the study of animal life, isn't it?
Animal acts?
Well, do you specialize? What do you specialize in?
Oh, nothing special.
I got it.
If I had a hammer?
Let me get that.
I like you. You're nice. You're pretty. But you're just a summer thing.
At the end of it, if we ever get off these islands, I'll never have anything to do with it again.
What will you do?
I'm going to eat a lot of bacon.
In Normandy. Like Norman women do.
Storm the beach at Normandy?
Huh? I'm a little dull after the life I've been living. Rather dull and alive than excited. And
I'll take a dull, alive woman every time.
I guess the other way would be kind of sick, wouldn't it?
Hmm. Is this hallway ever long?
Mm.
Just strain and stir it. Oh.
Say it, Thorn.
Thorn.
The autopsy has proved what we suspected.
He's dead. He's dead as vaudeville.
Several weeks ago, I concocted the most virulent poison I could with the materials I had at hand.
I had a free afternoon.
We put it out as bait. Mario Excuse was me. Killed by poison. Doctor, I wonder if you thought...
Now, back
the
off.
The system of the Sorex enabled them to assimilate that poison. It remained in the salivary glands of their jaws. Isn't that wonderful?
Why, it's better than Christmas.
I am sorry. Of course, I always speak from the clinical point of view.
I didn't mean to lash out.
Don't you have something to counteract that poison? Once Maria was bitten, I'm afraid there's nothing anyone could
she
have done.
She was bitten on the freighters? Mm.
This indicates that they cannot afford to get even so much as a scratch from these animals.
Too pricey.
They're more poisonous than snakes.
What do you think? I hate affected? Snakes.
Best way to find out is let them all bite you and see which bite you die after.
We might just all get help. That chance, hey. Jerry. You included.
Jerry,
Doctor,
Jerry,
I've
Ferry.
All the doors in the house. I suggest we do the same thing with this hall and this lab. It'll cut down the chances of getting in the front of the house. I think if we keep a close watch on those walls and windows in there, we might make it till daybreak.
Mm-hmm.
The walls are 2 feet thick, Stu. Do you think they have a chance to dig in? Of course there's a chance.
They have shovels.
Anywhere that plaster's off, that adobe's as soft as mush where that rain hit it.
So do they have any sort of closure on this issue?
Hey, who's trilling? Stop trilling out here. Lionel, stop trilling. Diana, stop trilling.
You know, the big twist in this movie is that the Shrews are good and they're just trying to do an intervention on the humans.
How deadly is that doggy in the window?
Dun, 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 dun. Oh, 5 minutes to happy hour.
Those two are coloring to pass the time over there.
But here's another possibility, Doctor.
Gin omelets.
It's very light out. It's going to be daylight soon.
And me want to go home.
We'll take the shrew that killed Mario and throw it over the fence and use it for bait. If they show up for it, of course, they'll run for the boats out. But if they don't, then I'll go down and have Rook lay to with a lighter. Then I'll return to the bend and the trail and give you the all-clear signal.
Could you back up a bit? The shrews
fine,
and...
fine, Captain.
Good. Then you explain it to the rest.
I will.
Sure. Hey, you guys, what's his name said something about the thingamajig?
Well, he's chasing rabbits in heaven now.
Well, I put the dog out. I lobbed him over the fence. Wasn't easy.
Well, the bait's been out for 20 minutes. Nothing's touched it.
Well, then I'm going to change my clothes. She is whisper thin.
Starsky, wait!
Neat, huh? Oh, wait, here's a trick I taught him. Stay, rot, good boy.
You know, we really need to rake.
Going on 17.
Even the wind has gone down. Isn't that wonderful?
I'm afraid it's not over, my dear.
The finger's not over?
There'll be a lot more.
He's right. I'll be back at the bend shortly. Now you watch for my signal.
Huh? You can't go alone.
I'll go with him.
Not you, Father. You haven't even fired a gun.
He doesn't love
you.
He'd
rather, Jerry.
Sure, I'll go.
If I die, it'd be a boon to the movie.
Then you'll be sure of getting the signal.
Ouch.
I gotta go make some raisin mash.
Here's a big pile of... Oh, here he comes.
Oh, hi, Cherry. Oh.
No, coast is clear. Look at...
Why don't they run to the boat and drive away?
Wow. Well, music sounds like Popeye.
Say, Jerry, I've been meaning to ask you, is that coat leather or vinyl?
Pleather, actually. You're gonna die from shrew bites. You're gonna die from shrew bites. Shrew bites. Shrew bites.
We've only got 20 rounds altogether. Hmm. I know that as well as you do.
Oh, we're in agreement then, aren't we?
Yep.
Servant, you stay away from her. You have that gun pointed at me? Right at the middle of your back.
Well, that is a part of me.
We've got enough problems without worrying about Anne. I'm telling you, stay away from her. When the shrews get through with you, they won't even find a buckshot.
Make it. Ooh. Now, that must be how Festus got his voice and his limp.
Snag on him. Snicker snag on him.
Now I'm going to send some shrews over here, Festus.
Hey, I thought the shrews only came out at night.
They probably woke them up with their fighting and all they're carrying on.
Spot out. Well, so. Oops.
Do, 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 do.
I'm back over here and I'm dead.
Don't do that, they're dogs.
Where's the skip?
Have you forgiven me for pointing that gun at you?
I'll follow that check line. I gotta find him. Since last night, you won't find much of him. Would you shut up? I'm not going back.
You what?
I'm staying here. All right. You shoot yourself, but if I were you, I'd swim out to that boat.
Shoot yourself? I heard.
Can't swim. And stay here.
Can't stand.
Wait a minute. You gotta give me a gun.
Are they doing their vaudeville act again?
Give you a gun? Sherman, wait!
Let's see, where is that skiff? No, it's around here somewhere.
Hey, wait up. Where do you think he is? I mean, you think he's dead or you think... You really think he's dead? How did you think he is? I like your shoes. Where'd you get your shoes? Am I bothering you? I'll try not to bother you. I won't say anything more ever again, or there I go again.
Well, either he's dead or they found Amelia Earhart's stuff.
Dick Tracy cap gun.
The gun we had on the boat. They don't leave much, do they?
I don't know. That's a shoe, a gun, a shirt, a belt, lots of stuff.
Sherman, we gotta make a deal for it.
Did I just step in what I think I stepped in?
Yep.
They've been trailing us on both sides. Where? I didn't see anything.
Hmm?
Yeah, they're starting the routine again.
You gotta give me a gun.
All right, but don't kill me, you promise?
Whatever you do, don't you run. You stay in front of me, because I don't trust you.
Folks, see what I gotta work with. Bye-bye.
You making shrew noises back there?
They're coming!
To take me away!
Don't run! Dogs can sense fear.
Put down your drinks and let me in.
He doesn't understand. They're just as frightened of you as you are of them, okay?
Speaking of drinks, you know, I got an idea.
Hey, evening, Mr. Servo. Evening, Mr. T-Robot.
Hello.
What can I do for you tonight?
Joel, buddy, it's a court of the three. No one in the place except you and me and Crow. Anywho, me and my amigo Crow here are going to show you how to mix a real drink.
Jump back, Joel, because this is not your average Pelican Calypso flip a hop, skip, and go zombie.
But it is one potent potable, and it's our very own Killer Shrew.
Okay, here I go. I'm at your service. What
okay,
do you want?
Okay, listen up. Chocolate ice cream.
Okay, chocolate ice cream.
Captain
Good.
Crunch with Crunch
okay,
Berry.
Yeah, Captain
yeah.
Crunch
peanut
with Crunch
M&Ms.
With
peanut
Mrs.
M&Ms.
Butterworth.
All right.
Circus Peanuts.
All right, Circus Peanuts.
Mr. Pibb.
Mr. Pibb. All right,
now
we got
Marshmallow
Mr. Pibb
peeps.
Over here.
Lots of Marshmallow Peeps.
Okay, Marshmallow Peeps. Isn't this going to be kind of sweet?
Just make the drink, okay. Barkeep. Sweet Tarts.
All right, Sweet Tarts. Got
Vanilla Frosting.
Vanilla
Good and
Frosting.
Plenty's.
Got that over here.
Wax Good. Lips.
No, Good no, no, no. Wax lips. You're thinking of the Vulcan Mind Probe.
All right. 86 to wax lips.
Right. Now, music, maestro, please.
All right. Ready? Okay.
So, you live around here much?
Hey, you see that weather?
Great hotel here. Up and down to the pool.
Aren't people here, phony?
All right. Pour that into the plastic tulip glass and garnish with a wind-up shrew.
Hey, you know what? This looks pretty good. You mind if I try it?
Be my guest.
Oh, it is ladies' night. Yeah, the feeling's right. Oh, ladies' night. Oh,
Frank.
And I want to dance with somebody.
New rule, Frank. Don't ever touch me.
Okay, buddy? What do you worry about you?
I'm fine.
Tasty. Here comes the Rat Pack.
Frank, Sammy, Dean, Joey.
Joey?
Catch me!
Mannix!
I never thought I'd be so happy to see a fight scene. Mm-hmm.
Stick it to him! I got money on you!
Hey, it's laughing, look!
Swing and a miss. Run away. Fall to
it. Ow. What's going on?
That's illegal.
For heaven's sakes, Doctor, stop him!
Doctor, stop him?
Come on, do it! Come on, you know you wanna!
Come on!
He's back at you.
Oh, come on, you big dummy. Oh, that stuff I gotta
know. I wish I could do that.
If you're not gonna buy a ticket, you can't watch the game.
Ooh, got him.
Well, I'll mix up a pitcher.
You better.
Oh, I was comforting her while you were gone.
Didn't he have it coming, or didn't he?
That's your conscience talking to you there.
What happened out there? Oh, nothing much. Jerry just tried to kill me twice in the last 5 minutes.
You know, same old, same old.
Yep.
Rook came ashore last night. Mm-hmm. He is dead.
Or he's naked somewhere, I don't know. It's kind of leaning that way.
This all was left. Won't do us any good, it's got no ammo.
Hey, looky, I found Ken Curtis, TV's lovable Festus. Can I keep him?
Just for that, you can't drink for an hour.
I'm deeply sorry, Captain.
Now Phyllis George is going to make him
I wish I'd followed your orders. Look, Doctor, you casually mentioned animals. You didn't explain to us what we were facing out there.
Dogs with weird stuff on them.
You have every right to feel the way you do. My mistake was only mine. It was one of judgment.
20 lashes with a wet noodle.
I didn't know about the hurricane. I didn't anticipate the effect it would have on the Shrews.
The Shmoo, the great Shmoo?
I thought the house would be safe through the crisis. How could you expose your own daughter? How could you expose Anne to that?
She's adopted.
She was going to leave last week, but the boat didn't come. I need a drink.
Oh, I wish you would just get mad at me.
Anybody else care for one? I could use some coffee.
I'll make some.
Thank you,
Adam. Good idea.
Cream and sugar.
Oh, no! Oh. Stay. You stay. Stay. Sit. Good dog. Stay. Good dog.
Well, I'm dead.
You all right, Doctor? You just ripped my trousers, that's all.
I'm fine,
sure,
really.
That's all. I'm completely aware of it, Doctor.
The end.
Yeah, enjoy in moderation, my ass. Ken, you better switch to coffee.
Yeah. The money is in the...
That was a stupid waste of ammunition. Tell everyone I'm a clean man. There's still 4 of them in there.
My hair, I... leave to Steve Allen, my sport coat, I leave to Bob Newhart.
Wow, he really cruised those 5 stages.
Hmm. Look at him, he looks weird without his glasses.
No.
Hey, Doctor, you okay?
Yeah.
He's dead.
He didn't even pay his part of the tab.
Check his wallet. What's this say here? Short little kraut? Wait a minute, conditions hellish? What's going on here? I don't even.
You recorded every symptom and reaction right up to the moment of his death.
But he's a terrible speller. Was with a Z.
Jerry, tear down one of those drinks and cover him up.
Tear down a drink?
Sure. Greg, I'll cover Anne, and I'll cover him. You'll cover me, but who'll cover you?
Hey, is this one of them funny joke riddles?
We can get on this man, old slaver.
She's my sister. She's my daughter. Well, somebody's going to jail, and that's not going to be me.
It'll take a tank to get us out of here.
Hello, Sheriff.
Not the couch. I just had it reupholstered.
That's nice. Good. Now, the lamp. The lamp would look nice. Get the floor lamp and bring it over here.
It won't take them all to dig around this. You're right.
Nope.
No telling where else they're digging, too.
Uh-oh.
Quick, get another couch! No, not the wet bar!
Oh, no! That'll hold him.
Come on, Patty!
Tucky.
We're gonna barbecue now?
There's not enough stuff here to barricade those walls. I'll tell you, we'll mount some of those crates up over there. That roof's our last chance.
Here, help. We're going to put on a show.
Find something light.
Hey, this is my beat.
Hey, I found a wheat penny. I'm keeping it.
Look at this, some great stuff in here. Check it out. Golf clubs. And...
Oh, he must be the Dr. Smith of this movie.
Yeah.
Doctor, yes. Use these chemical drums as tanks. Hmm. Individual tanks.
Sort of like a personal pan pizza.
Look down now.
Oh, it's really cool in here. Bang a hammer on it for me. That, no, nothing, nothing. I wasn't doing anything. Just hanging around back here.
It'll work.
Yes.
But these drums are too tall for the bass. If the shoes don't push us all the way, the wind will. Not if we lash them together.
Well, they're not really personal tanks anymore, are they?
Only that one over there.
Where?
Oh. Have any cold chisels or hammers or anything I can knock a hole in here and make five pieces?
I'm gonna put a wet bar in mine.
Hey, you know what? I bet we could do something with these wings.
Yeah, help out a little bit.
Hey, here's another one.
Neat, bigger than the other one.
What a quirky day.
What? True be gone. Hey, we're saved.
What are they doing? Oh, it's Flash Dance. He's an exotic dancer at night.
He's a maniac.
He's an idiot.
Get some rope and put it on that latch so we can reach it from the ground.
Okay.
It's all the same to Mary Lou. Calf riding, broody contest, escaping killer shrews.
Yep.
Wait a minute. They can chew through adobe but not wood?
Huh.
I'm getting
Poke him.
Hey, I changed my mind. I think they're going to be submarines.
Watch that torch. 2 weeks later.
Hi.
How about a little fire, doggy?
Oh,
hot dog.
Ooh.
He bit my hinder.
Ouch.
So what we're doing here, Bob, is this.
4 weeks later.
Does this plan take more than a month?
Hold this in, all right?
Hold it tight.
I call a front seat.
When bad dogs happen to good people. Umbrella.
Oops. A little pause. Cute little pause.
All right, we're all set.
We are? How can you tell?
But we should be able to duck walk to the beach.
Oh, get Chuck Berry. Jerry, this is Father O'Malley, boy. Get down from there, will you?
See if you can coax him down here.
Jerry, please come down with us.
No, I am. They'll get you if you go. Come down here, you fool.
Darn fool kid.
Hey, we got some cutty down here. Nummy, nummy, Jerry.
Case of Jim.
A fiddler on the roof. How fortunate.
Well, let's just hope the dogs don't like sardines.
Ooh.
Well, I gotta go to the bathroom.
Why did Phyllis ever up before?
Come on, kiss your auntie.
Okay, now somebody's gotta get the door.
Everybody ready? I'm gonna open that gate.
Now let's not walk in four different directions.
Ready?
I guess.
Okay, here they come.
Walking down the street. Get fabulous.
Hold on!
Hi! It'll never get off the ground.
Nope.
Regrets? I've had a few. I changed my mind!
I'm feeling very alone right now.
Dad!
Dad, what's the matter?
Oh, nothing. What do you think?
You want a rest? You tired?
Should we pull over?
I can't hear you. It sounds like you're in a barrel.
She says she's all right. She's keeping her eyes closed. All right, keep your eyes closed.
Keep your feet on the ground and keep reaching for the stars.
I'm still here, Heifer.
The septic room is too heavy for her. I can barely hold up my side.
I'll say.
I'll be all right in a minute.
You go on without me.
All right. You walk. I'll drag for a while.
Those dogs got him under a barrel.
Listen, don't let their head get under. They'll flip us over.
Oops. I'm huge. Nice, huh?
Sure wish I had one of them anti-shrew barrels.
Yeah, I hope the bar's still open down there.
Nice socks. You know, even Asbestos, I admired his hosiery.
Oh, that is nice hosiery. I'll need this. I better take this.
A life preserver?
Yep.
That might be kind of ineffectual against killer shrews.
Well, it is a life preserver, though.
Oh, true,
I mean, you know.
True. You know, that stump has been the cause of death for a lot of people.
Get him! It's Festus Buffet!
He's really tasty! Not a life preserver, and texture!
Come on, you guys.
Meanwhile, on the Merrimack here. Oops.
He got my foot!
Well, give it to him!
My foot is free, but he got my boot!
Is there a scratch?
Did you save the receipt?
No, not
a mark. Hey, he's in a portable confessional.
Okay, it's Alva.
Oh, sorry.
Ooh.
Oh, that hurt.
Full speed ahead.
Okay, I think this movie just broke the goofy meaning.
I agree.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No, I don't think I... What?
Oh, come on. The movie would have ended 5 minutes ago if it weren't for your stupid boots.
Please, Dan.
She gets this way. You'll have to excuse her.
We'll hit the water soon.
Then we'll sink.
Good. Great.
Dive.
Doesn't sound like they're following us anymore.
Oh, my aching dogs.
Woof.
Oh, yes. Yes.
We better work deeper.
Deeper. Deeper.
I'm not going to
swim for it.
Okay.
Oh no, piranhas!
Sharks!
Oh! Agents!
There we go.
Well, bad news, folks. I left the keys on the bar.
Don't!
Well,
unless
I'm on board, Tricia. We are safe, aren't we?
I'm in the
storm.
Me too.
Sure.
What?
She rode out the first half all right, and that's always the roughest. Anyway, riding an anchor, I was... a chance to learn a little more about that Swedish accent.
24 hours, there'll be one shrew left on the island.
To carry on, to carry on.
An excellent example of overpopulation.
Well, you know something, Doctor? What's that?
Your daughter's hot.
I'm not going to worry about overpopulation just yet.
We're getting out of here.
Get the suits up. Hey, hold it, you guys. Hey, I know we wanted to do a killer shrew sketch, sometime in this experiment, but these costumes just aren't cutting it.
Oh! 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 Oh!
Death feels like when it's a really nice Sunday afternoon, but you keep the shades down and you're home watching the Channel 9 movie and the announcer says, "We will be back after Harry and Walter go to New York." No, must read letter before I go. What the heck?
Did I tell you my saliva is poisonous?
Put it up on still, Sir Canva. I am 15 years old and a huge fan of your incredibly funny show. Though you may not remember, perhaps we got through the pants up song. It was incredibly funny and extremely clever, along with the Patrick Swayze Christmas Carol and Catalina Capers Creepy Girl song. You guys were very clever. And Mr. Sanchez, this is Sean Cable. I also present you with my favorite show award. Put that up on still, Sir Canva, please. You know, only the support and love of loyal MST3 viewers can save us from killer shrews. And Ariel, why don't you tell them the information, shrew Tom Servo?
Please, for the health and well-being of all of us on the satellite of love, please send your information and your letters to Mystery Science Theater 3000 Information Club. Post office box 5025. I'll get rid of somebody. Oops.
My tummy hurts. I had too much killer shrew.
Oh, there, Frankie. Here, I fixed you something nice.
Thanks, what is it?
An Epicac.
Got loose, any unusual experiment can produce unusual results.